টারবাইনে আমি তো যেটা পাঠালো সব
Sir, please start.
Yeah, is the PPT?
Yes, sir, visible.
Visible, okay. So, students, today I'll talk about a chapter which talks about management of company under the company law. In the last class, I told you what are the various types of companies and how a company is incorporated. And if you really try to understand the company law, you can divide it into three. One is creation, formation of a company, then various kinds of capital, which I'll discuss. And the next is how the company is managed. And company is managed by two entities. One is by board of directors, another is by shareholder. Shareholders have a huge role to play in the company. And thereafter, the last phase is the end of a company. When you talk of end of a company, it is ending voluntarily or it is ending compulsory. That is, the government is forcing you to close down your company. We'll talk about it later. So today I'll be talking to you about management of a company, how the company is managed. Now, when you talk about management of a company, under the company law, company is managed by the board of directors. Company is managed by the board of directors. Before that, let me tell you that this board of directors can be owner or they can be professional people. When I say professional means that you are not the owner of the company, but you are hired. You are appointed to manage the company. That is called professional management. But professional does not mean that whether you are professionally qualified or not, that is not an issue. Point is whether you are the owner of the company or not. That is the test. Now, if you go for a company managed by owners versus company managed by professionals, there is a significant difference in the management philosophy and concept. Now, on the top, we have got shareholders who are on the top. Because shareholders own the company, they are the owners of the company, and obviously they can decide whatever they do under the provisions of the Companies Act. Who are professionals? Professionals are owner-managed company. That is family-managed business, family-managed. Now, just imagine that in India, the biggest company, one of the biggest company, Reliance Industries, is a family-managed business. But the people who are managing, they are professionally qualified. But what we'll say? We'll say it is a family-managed business. Owner managed business, owner or directors of the company. Owners can hire professional but keep control with them. So what happens? How they keep the control as a shareholder? And in many companies you'll find the owner is the chairman. The managing director is a professional. He's hired because of his qualification and experience. But the chairman is the owner. So owner will try to keep control in that way. Now, some owners want to be a dormant investor. That means they'll be investor only. And all managerial decisions are left with the professional manager. You'll be surprised to know in India, some of the companies, that the owner is saying, I don't want to be the chairman also. Let the chairman also be the outside. And we've got a great example of Tata Group. So the chairman of the group is not owner. He is not a substantial shareholder of the company. So that is up to the owner to decide. He can decide to be a dormant investor. And when you say professionally managed, that person is not the owner of the company. So owner managed company is also called promoter managed company. And some of the companies fully take the case of ITC. The CMD of ITC is a professional. He's not representing the promoters. He's not the owner. So he has become MD out of his professional qualification experience. But nothing to worry about it, because in India, 99% of Indian business are owner managed. 99% of Indian companies are managed by the owners. And that is a normal business concept where you will find that, you know, all the kind of business around you, various shops, small companies, they are managed by the owners themselves. The owners themselves are managed. So this is the basic concept of company management. And when you talk of company management, there are certain theories which are based that when you have a company, the company is controlled by Memorandum Association and Articles of Association. Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association of a company. All of you know Memorandum and Articles, I presume. Memorandum is the charter of the company having specifically 4-5 sections. So we've got in Memorandum, we have got the name clause, the object clause, what is the object of the company. Company cannot go beyond the objective. It also talks about the situation where the registered office of the company will be situated. Most important, the capital of the company. What will be the capital of the company? And liability. What will be the liability of the shareholders? And all the shareholders will subscribe. Yes, we are the people who have subscribed this shares of this company, and we are forming a company. That is called subscription law. That is called subscription. These are the six clauses of a memorandum. Articles of association talk about internal regulations of the company, how the company shall be regulated. It will talk about how the meetings will be held, how the directors will be appointed, what are the types of directors will be there in the company, where the documents will be kept, what will be the quorum of the meeting, how the minutes will be recorded. So everything will be there, internal management system will be there in the article. Both management, both memorandum and articles has to be within the framework of the Companies Act. Supposing that there is a clause in the articles which is contradicting the Companies Act, the Companies Act will override the provisions of the articles of association. Companies Act will override the provisions of the Articles of Association. So whenever the company is making an Articles of Association, the company has to take care of the provisions of the Companies Act. These two documents are called constitutional documents. Some of you are keeping any copy book in front of you, please note down that these documents are called constitutional documents. So this is the document on the which the company is constituted. And along with that, you have to give a declaration of compliance by a practicing CACS or CMA or an advocate that the company has complied with the provisions of the company that so far formation rules are concerned. And in addition to that, you have to give one, the director. First director will give an affidavit saying that they have not been convicted of any offense which disqualifies them to be director of the company. All these documents are to be uploaded and then your company will be registered. Once registered, company will get a certificate for certificate of incorporation, and that will serve as the birth certificate of the company. Now the company is made, there are certain principles on which the company will function. These principles have been taken out from various rules, regulations, practice, and for a long time, or